Some commenting. Hello, welcome, hello, thank you for the invitation. I hope that I will cover the topic sufficiently. I will try to show you some of our slides. Unfortunately, Ms. Rita Galli was not able to attend, so I will be in her place. So I will talk as the operator of the national system for the natural gas. We have a system that is now developing, and it is developing because the market is developing towards new directions, towards new fields, sectors that are added to the system, and towards the west, towards the south. This is being developing. We have new interconnections in the south, a system towards northern Macedonia. We have new interconnections. There are new FSRU units that are added to the system, new sources of entry. And in the future, we hope we will have the storage facility in Kavala that will also strengthen the security of supply and will help us be more competitive in terms of the pricing for the natural gas. So we see a system that is developing and we need to invest in it by to meet the requirements of the market. But when we make these investments, we need to look forward. These investments must meet the requirements of the country for the next 20 to 30 years. We cannot look only towards gas. So what is changing? We are going to an energy transition. Everyone knows it by now that the Green Deal is based on three things. First is energy savings. Second is electricity and decarbonization. And third are biogases, renewable gases. So we understand that hydrogen, also gas, will have its place in the new system. Hydrogen, of course, in order to have this place in the system, the hydrogen market must be sustainable, must be reliable. We need to have a reliable system in the future, and it has to be developed in a cost-effective manner, at least for the consumers. Without going into all the technicalities and the different colors of the hydrogen, we know that we are going to promote in the future what we call the green hydrogen based on renewable energy sources, perhaps blue energy for the consumers as well, but also the turquoise, if it is developed, it will play a part as well. As the operator of a transmission system, we can say that we are true in terms of the color. We are going to we are blind in terms of the color. We do not. We are going to transport the gas that we have to for the market. Nonetheless, we want to play a part in developing this future framework. And what we do can be summarized on different levels. The ultimate goal, of course, is the green hydrogen coming from RES. I think we are all active in all the European Union forums, in all discussions to help develop the regulatory system, regulatory framework, specifically for hydrogen. We are also active on a national level. We are participating in the national committee that is planning the national strategy for hydrogen. We try to help whenever we can with our views and our position in order to formulate this framework. And of course, we are entering, hopefully dynamically, with some pilot project in order to highlight the importance of hydrogen and renewable gases in the future system. Let me also note that we have proceeded and we have started formulating a strategy that will go up to 2050. So far, our plans had a 10-year horizon. This one goes further because that's how we need to do it. What we sometimes forget, even though we talk a lot about about hydrogen, sometimes we forget the role of biomethane. We don't have production of biomethane in Greece, and I don't think it's necessary to explain why. We try to enter this cycle to highlight the value chain of the industry with the collection of biomass and the processing of biogas and the upgrading of this biogas into biomethane, which is a useful fuel. What is biomethane? It is methane, green methane, that comes from renewable sources. Therefore, it is a fuel that can be produced at significant quantities, I would say, in our country, which means that other productions can be reduced, and it does not need any conversion. The system, the transport system for the gas, does not need any conversion, or the final consumers as well. It's just methane. Aside from that, we participate, as Mr. Papaloukas said, to two projects, as IPCEI projects. The first one is the White Dragon, and our proposal in the White Dragon can be analyzed as follows. Renewable hydrogen will be produced in the area of West Macedonia, and this hydrogen which will be produced there at the first level will be channeled to the pipeline that is being built in the area of West Macedonia, and then it will enter the system of natural gas transport. So this new pipeline has to be able to accept, has to be ready for hydrogen, 100% ready, but the transport system as well has to be able to accept at least a percentage of hydrogen at the same time, because we think, we know that this is a transitional solution. We need to look at where it is possible to produce hydrogen or where it is possible to store hydrogen, so we can design the future pipeline that will be exclusively for hydrogen. And our third phase of our participation in the White Dragon project includes the interconnection of the south, Corinth, Athens, the industrial parks in Thessaloniki, and we will also move to the east because there is a need for consumption there and perhaps the possibility to store. But we will also see the possibilities for interconnection with the systems in the north. So this hydrogen that will be produced in our country in the future could perhaps be channeled, be directed to the north, and the markets can be interconnected so that we can have this security of supply and create a new market for hydrogen. This project, we can look at it independently as well, because it is not just a project of White Dragon. Even if it is not funded, the question is not if it will happen, the question is when it will happen, and the sooner the better, so that we can develop the hydrogen economy in Greece. This project, this pipeline, will be interconnected with the Blue Net as well, something that IPCEI was proposed by Motorola. This is all from my side. I think I was brief enough.